This is kind of an unusual model, it's not usually the way restrooms don't tend to operate like this, so it's definitely a little. It's crazy, in fact, I have to update our number, we've done 412 adoptions, most of the dogs that we adopt out tend to be seniors or medical needs dogs. Those are the ones we generally focus on. The shelter has had. No, no, they have medical needs, like they may have.
Oh, the dog is.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I thought you meant partnering.
Yeah, no, nope, that's not something to do, no, that would be great, but no. So sometimes, like, for example, one of the ones that's out walking right now, Ruby, she's considered medical needs, but they've already taken care of it. She had, she came into the shelter with a severe injury to her eye, and so they had to remove her eye, so she recovered and so that's all right now. She's not going, huh?
Going anywhere.
She'll go that way.
No, she doesn't like stairs.
So, yeah, they get to come up, it's a nice, even if they don't get adopted, we bring up the same dogs, you know, we just continue to bring the same one.
Yeah.
And the idea is the longer they're at the shelter, the more likely they are to come, you know.
But I think we just keep.
Because it's super stressed out, because right now they have 600 dogs there, and we should have about 250. So they're more than double capacity, and it's just terribly stressful for them. So they come up here, and it's really a nice place for them to decompress and relax for the day.
But he's a nursery shepherd.
And then we get some that are, the dog, the first time he came up here, he didn't want anybody to touch his head, and it made him really nervous, and now he leans in and rubs his head on you almost like a cat, and yeah, so. It really does help for a lot of them to overcome some of their fears of nervousness. But yeah. But then it's definitely worth it.
I hope they all get adopted.
Well, thank you. He's hopefully going home this afternoon, fingers crossed. So, yes.
It's like,
do it some more. Do it some more, Brian.
I think that's why he was stressed out yesterday, because he's here. He's like, you're so happy to be here. He's like, where's Brian?
Yeah.
It's the first day I'm here. Where's Brian? He's always here on the first day.
I'm surprised Brian didn't come up yesterday to see him.
Well, I sent him pictures, and he sends me back a text. I could have sworn I told you he was coming up. So he sends me back a text. He says, is that Argo? And I'm like, well, duh. Thank you. That would be Choo-Choo, guaranteed.
What is going on? Are you a crier? Or you just don't like being separated
from your family? At first, we could go 10 feet without
turning around and hugging. Choo-Choo? Yeah. And then you kind of finally
get him
dog.
Going on, and then something's tracking you.
Right? I think he needs to be with somebody that'll be. I actually tried to talk her into going to meet him. Because I think with his separation anxiety, she's home all the time. Mm. I think he would do better with her. And he's much easier to control.
Yeah.
So. I just hate the idea that he might go to somebody that doesn't bring him into it. That's what concerns me.
Right.
How many times is he going to be able to bounce back and forth before he finally breaks?
Yep.
Oh, Argo. You're such a goober.
Are you getting treats?
You're just such a good girl.
That face is killing me.
You know, I really shouldn't let the date that I have on there for him isn't right. Argo, I should put the original date that he was at back. October 6th of last year. The 117, that was when he came back from the long experience that we had with him. I didn't feel good when he left with her. I just really didn't. I also didn't think she was going to keep all of the stuff that I sent home with either.
Yeah.
I thought that was obnoxious, especially since she didn't have any other dogs to use with.
That lady?
The one, the first one that took him home?
Uh-huh.
The really nice harness that Sandy had brought in to me because
yes.
it didn't fit her dog.
She didn't bring it back with him?
She, nope. The leash, the collar, none of it. Because I checked with PACC staff and yeah, it didn't come back.
What was she going to do with him?
He was good.
He did. He was styling. Hello.
Hi.
How are you folks today? Yeah, you can walk through. There's two that are out on walks right now, but we've got two here, and then there's two others in the back kennels. And all of these dogs come from Pima Animal Care Center.
Don't you think?
Hi.
Like I do. I'm the welcoming committee. He's like, I know how this is supposed to work. I come up and say hi.
I'm too busy over here.
We need to have him give some lessons before he leaves later.
What is she doing?
She's looking for food.
Without like having to move her
yeah.
car.
She doesn't want to get
treats.
Out.
Doggy treat.
She doesn't feel comfortable with me just yet, so she's...
She's working on it.
Yeah.
Yep.
Can you have more treats?
Yep.
Ginger? I know that was an accident, but it was a cute accident.
Well, you know, Tootsie's probably going to cry the whole time that.
Oh, I'm sure.
Ginger's so much.
He's very dramatic. He's yeah. dramatic on a good day, anyway.
Yeah. Where did they
pick him?
Good job, Ginger.
Very picky. Sometimes I have to remember.
Okay,
you
know
he
ate it.
Oh, good job.
Can you sit nice and clean?
Thank you.
Huh? How are you? You sit so pretty.
Thank you so much for coming in. You guys have a great day.
You too.
Thank you.
So maybe we'll come here and push you on the race.